Someone over here is listening to music very loudly. One and two. If you have something else, keep your hand up. And then everyone choose three or five. Remember that translating is not something you can do in Desmos. You have to know how to translate. So the product of everything after that, we're multiplying those two things together. A number and four divided by three. So pick some variable, multiply it by four, and divide it all by three. Questions on that one? For your line of estimate, those, did I have the notes correctly? Because I kept going back and forth. And then if I type in my y1, the tilde, mx1, plus b, we would get y equals negative 1.5x, or y equals negative 1.5x plus 0, either or. And then to combine like terms, we need to distribute. We have 2x minus 3z plus 4x minus 4z minus 6z minus 10x. And then combine all of your x's. So this would be 6 minus 10 is negative 4. X and combine all of your z's. So negative 7 minus 6 is negative 13. And if you wanted to double check that in Desmos, you could not do it in Desmos, but double check it by putting the original in, adding sliders, making the x's capital, and then putting this in. And you would get that. Anyone need to see that in Desmos or have questions on any of those? add in all the sliders, change them to two different numbers, doesn't matter what they are, and then put in your answer. And the decimal should be the same. And that's what you need to do. Look at your rational exponents notes. We're going to finish that today. Now some of the bottom ones are in radical form. We're going to convert it back to exponential form and then do all those steps. So let's start with 29. So how would I write the cube root of v in exponential form? Denominators, so we have to make them the same and multiply these by 3 and this by 2. So we have v to the 2 6 plus 3 6, which would give us 5 6 v to the 5 6. And then how would I write this in radical form? Sixth root of v to the 5th power. Questions on that one? So it's really the same process, it's just an extra step in there. Question 30. How would I rewrite this? The 4th root of r cubed. R to the 3 over 4, and then the square root of R?
R to the
1 half. R to the 1 half. Again, add our exponents, but change this fraction. I'm going to multiply both by 2. So we have R to the 3 fourths plus 2 fourths, which would give us 5 fourths. R to the 5 fourths. And then because we have an improper fraction, I'm going to split this. 4 goes into 5 how many times? Once. So that's going to be 4 over 4 with 1. This guy left over. 4 over 4 would simplify to be 1. So just that 1r. And then how would I write this in radical form? The 4th root of r. That kind of got smushed there. But r times the 4th root of r. We did a lot of the ones on this page. Are there Any others in 31 through 34 that we want to see do go over have fun as well?
34.
Let's start off with rewriting this in exponential form. How would we do that? So, because these two are different things, we want to separate that.
So, like, wouldn't that be only exponential?
This would be n to that power, but it's also going to be to that root. So 25 is not going to be to the 2/4. 25 is just going to be to the 1/4. But m is going to be to the
2/4.
Yes. For now, we still have to simplify it. Now, I know that 25 is the same thing as 5 squared, so I'm going to rewrite that as 5 squared to the 1/4, and I know this can be simplified to 1/2. If I were to multiply the exponents, we would multiply. If I multiplied those, what would the new exponent of 5 be? It'd be 2/4, so 1/2. I'll write both so you see. So then, because these are both 1/2, we can change this back to the square root. And put them both together. So sometimes you don't end up with what you start with. If it can be simplified, if you could rearrange it, change it, and it simplifies.
And how do you do 13?
So you would rewrite them first into exponential form. How would we write this one? The numerator. 7 to what power?
2/3.
Close, but backwards?
3.
3/2. And then how would I write the denominator?
7/2.
1/2. And we're dividing like bases, so we're doing what with the exponents? Subtraction. So that would be 7 to the 3 over 2 minus 1/2, which would give us 2/2, which is just 1. So your final answer would just be 7. If I were to put some of these, a lot of these you can double check in your calculator also. So if I were to put that in the calculator, square n that up. And I put in the square root. Of 7 cubed and the square root of 7. That's not what we do. We get 7. Questions on that or any others? Alright. So we're going to stop there because we don't need to do any others. You guys can practice these notes. The delta math for this is due on Friday. The delta math for simplifying radicals is due on Friday. You guys have your test nav that's due on Monday, 8 through 14. hacks, they'll come out. JLab, plenty of things to be working on. Uses my